Last summer I was an intern at the Department of Energy, Office of Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy, and I got a chance to actually witness firsthand what we're doing at a national level for sustainability, energy efficiency, and renewable energy. It gave me a great opportunity to learn as a student what I could do at my campus to outreach to these students and get them involved with the clean energy economy. My first link was actually to work with UCF Sustainability in a large energy competition called Kilowatt.
Residence halls are competing against each other of equal size to maintain a greater energy savings. At the end of each month, residents receive $50 scholarships from SGA for attending these events.
These are the buildings, the 14 buildings that are achieving at least a 15% or greater reduction in energy.
Normally we have it for a 1 month period. This time we extended it to 2.5 months. And we wanted to encourage greater student awareness and engagement. So we're doing this seminar for people to learn more about how to save energy and how they can get rewards from doing great efforts.
In Central Florida, we're in predominantly a cooling mode. So we would ask the students when we're in the cooling mode to be able to raise their set point to a number that's energy conscious, somewhere around 74 degrees is what we're looking for a set point on cooling. And then when they go to class, which students are away most of the time during the day, raise that set point to raise that up to as much as 80 degrees.
When you're leaving for class, make sure to unplug your curling iron and your blow dryer, because not only does it waste a lot of energy, but it's a fire hazard.
Another large energy consumer is appliances that we plug into the wall. And the problem is a lot of the times, whether or not they're plugged into an actual appliance, they're using power light through something called vampire or phantom power. Plug this in to a power cord, and when not in use, let's say you go to class, you could simply turn this power cord right off, shutting off the energy to all of these plugs and allowing us to conserve just that much more while you're in class. Pressing that elevator button uses energy automatically. To start using the stairs, not only is it energy conservative, but it actually is good for you. In 2009, we did the Kilowatt competition in the month of February, where we saved an average of 15% in each building and a total of $27,000 in our housing complexes.
We've noticed overall a really good savings. It's not necessarily based on the building or habits, it's more or less we've noticed that it does change each year. Some buildings you get a little bit more support and coverage from the students, you get a little bit more effort, you should say, but overall we've seen really good savings from a lot of the buildings. We have several winners every year that reach the tier of say 20 or 18 to 20, sometimes even a little bit more than that percent savings.
That last month, if your building does 20%, you actually can turn in an essay for $200 and pick that.
We've saved like 15 or 20% of energy, and that next time, if they're gonna do a next like drawing or something for the next building that saves more, and that we could possibly like win stuff.
Please save some more money, because I don't want tuition hikes. I still have a little time left here. So I just want them to save money and just
knock my tuition down.
When it came down to it, the savings that we saw in these buildings were very small tasks performed by the students that collectively led to a drastic savings of $27,000 and an average of 15%.
It just is a wonderful way of helping them appreciate the numerous ways in which we can save and conserve energy. The big energy problems we're facing, some will be solved by big advances in technology, but a lot are going to be solved by constant attention to detail, the little ways that we can all save and conserve energy.